beats you, punches you, heat up your car.
All she ever does is abuse you. I've seen the way you fight. Why do you put up with her crap?
You know I would never hit a woman.
911, what's your emergency?
They killed my boyfriend. I will kill you.
You don't scare me.
Well, the title of the movie is To Love the Soul of a Woman. And I learned a long time ago that when God calls you to do something, you already have the tools to do it with. And normally, you don't have to go inside yourself to try to figure out how and why you're doing something. So when I became a writer, I had to come to terms with that. And as such, through the years, I just write. I just do what I do. I direct and I act. As far as what made me do it about a male being abused, it's very common. It's way more common than people realize. 3.2 million cases a year is domestic violence against men, but people just don't talk about it. So I like doing things that are realistic. And when I decided to do this movie, I did it because it was realistic, it was up to date, and it was happening and it needed to be talked about. Well, let me say this first. The film is not about me, okay? It's about Ernest Anderson. I am the actor, and Sidney Poitier told Denzel Washington back when he was doing Training Day, acting is what we do, it's not who we are. As such, to move into the question, any person has the right to defend himself no matter who it's against. The key is how far you take it is a choice. It's always a choice. A man is always going to be physically stronger, bigger, more powerful than a woman. And even the toughest woman, if a man hits her, she going down. So he chooses to abuse her or to hit her in such a way that is going to cause her way more pain than it takes to get her off of him. I do feel that scorned women will have a tendency to emasculate men. However, just as it's a man's choice to hit a woman, it's a woman's choice to emasculate or to strike out at men. Just because she was abused when she was little, or maybe she was abused now in a previous relationship, she still chooses to go the same route as far as striking a man or emasculating him, degrading him in any way. I do feel to some large degree that men are responsible for the way that women behave. I always say the easiest way to be successful in your relationship is just listen. 9 times out of 10, women are going to tell you how they feel. 9 times out of 10, they're going to tell you what they want. And many times, they'll get mad about some of the simplest things, but they too are at fault. It's not a one-sided situation. My feelings on young black men. Well, here's the most important thing to me. In order for a young black man to be successful, he has to have successful people around him. One of my primary things, I am a high school basketball coach. I've also mentored, I've gone into young adult prisons and talked to young people. And one of the main things that I always say is surround yourself with the right people. When you surround yourself with the right people, then the opportunities are endless. The movie is currently being distributed coast to coast in Walmart. Now that's big, because a lot of people says, oh, I got a movie out. Okay, out where? Out what? Okay, what, you're at the flea market? But it's being distributed in Walmart, coast to coast. It's a great feeling to walk into Walmart and look on the shelf and say, hey, that's me right there.